bright sun. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more.
Morning again, everyone. Scott Pyre, Pop Cult Fan here. And as I mentioned in my previous video, I'll be reviewing the newest Fear Street movie, Fear Street Part 2, which is the second film in a trilogy of horror films that were originally novels written by R.L. Stein, who also wrote the original Goosebumps novels. So I think before I think what I'm going to do for this video is that I'm going to talk about the positives first and then talk about the things that I did not like as much with this movie, because I did not like this movie that much. I liked the first film a lot more than I liked this one. So I'm going to talk about the positives first. And also, I finally have them memorized the name of the town. The Shady Side. So, past me from past video, the name of the town is Shady Side. There you go. So, for the positives, I do think, I like how this movie kind of delved a little bit more into the lore of this supernatural threat that has been plaguing the town for generations. And also, I like how, because this movie takes place in 1978, I do think that this movie does a better job of recreating that time period with this camp that this group of kids and teenagers are in. That just, you know, I think they do a better job with the 1970s setting in this movie. And I also think that I like the lead actress in this movie. I thought she was okay. I thought she was good in her role. And also, I like how this movie, even though it's flashing back to 1978, it does continue the storyline that took place in the 94 film. So it is a sequel, but it's also a prequel. So I like that aspect of this movie. Now, and also, like, the whole lore, and we got to see a little bit more of what this supernatural entity or threat is. We got to see a little bit more of that backstory, and we're going to see that even more fleshed out in the third film. So, those are really all my positives. So, I really did not like the characters in this movie. For the most part, almost all of them are just really frustrating or annoying to watch. And even though I liked the music in this movie, they used it way too often. It's the same complaints that I have about the first Suicide Squad movie, where there's like so many songs featured in the film, and it's like I'm just listening to the music half the time. And when I get to the end of the movie, when the movie is wrapping up, there's like music playing over the scene of the movie ending, and it's just doesn't need to be there. So there's a lot of music that's just overused in this movie that I just did not like how that was used. But I mean, I liked the music, like, because it takes place in 1978, there's a lot of music in the movie that I do like, that I listen to a lot often, especially one particular song that I used in my MCU tribute video a week ago. There was one song in particular that I used in my MCU tribute video that was featured in this movie, Carry On Wayward Son. I'm a really big fan of that song. It's one of my favorite songs from that time period, because I watched Supernatural a lot growing up, and as you guys can see, I'm wearing a Supernatural shirt for this video. Carry On Wayward Son is kind of like the ending theme of Supernatural in every season of that show. So naturally, when I heard the song in this movie, I really enjoyed it. It's just, they used the music way too much in this movie. So that's another major flaw I have with Fear Street Part 2. And also, even though this movie does up the body count of the first film, there's just not a lot of original kills of this movie. It's just a lot of axe kills that we've seen countless times in a lot of other horror films. So not a whole lot of originality with the kills in this movie either. So I have a lot more flaws with this movie than I did with the first Fear Street film. So if I had to give a grade for this movie, it would be a C+. So mixed feelings for this one. So yeah, that should do it for this video. Like, I know that I was a little bit more critical with this film. I just did not like it as much as the first film. Hopefully the third film, Fear Street Part 3, which takes place in 1666, which is kind of the origin of the supernatural threat. I don't want to say what it is. I don't want to spoil it. But if you've seen the trailers, I mean, you'll know what it is just based on watching the trailers alone. So yeah, there's that. So hopefully the third film will be better than this. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you all in the next video. Peace. Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion, I was soaring ever higher.